dynamic atlas of science, meaning that it would generate the usual co-citation clustering maps, but you would recluster the file based on every week's accumulation of data, let's say, and then you would generate a new map every week, and then you could project the image of that map as a moving target so that you could see how new fields were emerging in a very visual, dynamic way. Whereas now you've got to kind of extrapolate visually from one year to the other. I mean, you could cluster every year, but the changes are significant because of the way in which the clustering occurs, whereas on a week-by-week basis, you probably wouldn't, it would be not as sensitive to the changes, right? So that's an experiment that still ought to be done. I think it would be fascinating to see it. Hasn't the memory changed in such a way you could do that in such a way?
I'm pretty sure we could do it.
Can that be done on a PC with multiple gigabytes of memory?
Yeah.
I think people would love that. And it's something we always wanted to do. That's the kind of visual display we should have had for that thing they were having in New York, not this other stuff. They have that exhibit, by the way, down at Oak Ridge at the Science Museum.
Yeah. It's very static.
And your picture's up on the wall, by the way. Which I was very proud of. So that was another interesting project that we didn't quite complete. Something that needs to still be done, I think, could be very useful. And I think we'd all get over the hump of people's resistance to using that sort of thing.